हॅलो स्टुडंट्स, आय एम डॉक्टर कल्पक कदरकर, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन. आय वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस सेरीज ऑफ बायोस्टॅटिस्टिक्स लेक्चर्स. दिस इज अ थर्ड लेक्चर इन द सेरीज. इन प्रिवियस लेक्चर्स वी हॅव कवर्ड अबाउट द मेजर्स ऑफ द सेंट्रल टेंडन्सी, इन विच वी हॅव कवर्ड अबाउट द मीन, मेडियन अँड मोड. अँड इन सेकंड लेक्चर वी हॅव कवर्ड अबाउट द मेजरमेंट्स ऑफ द व्हेरिएशन्स, इन विच वी हॅव सीन range, interquartile range, mean deviation, standard deviation. If you have not gone through the previous lectures or practicals, please refer that, because to understand the concept of the normal distribution, we should have the knowledge about the mean and the standard deviation so that we can easily understand the concept of the normal distribution. So let's begin. This is our lecture cum practical. So the learning objectives of the today's lecture cum practicals are: understand the concept of the normal distribution, and second one, understand the concept of the standard normal curve and its application. So coming to these first two points, we have to understand two concepts here. First, the concept of the normal distribution of the data, and second one is the application and the concept of the standard normal curve. These are the two different things. And third one is estimate the number of individuals in any range of measurements. So this will give you the hands-on training or the practical application of this normal distribution concept. And fourth one is to understand the concept of the skewness and the kurtosis. To understand the concept of normal distribution of data, first it is important to understand the concept of the different types of data distribution. On screen you can notice there are three figures. So these three figures explain you the different types of the data distribution. So in first point, you can see the data is spread out more on the left. Take an example of the MCQ test of the 150 marks having the 150 MCQ, and suppose the MCQs are so much easy. So all of you, or all of the students of your class, scores more than 100 marks. In that case, if we do the graphical representation or frequency distribution, we can get the students scoring more than 100 marks or 120 marks are 20 students, 25 students, and very less students scoring the mark 40, 60, 70 or 80. In that case, your data will be spread out more on the left side. Now the second example, if the data is, when the data will be spread on more on the right side. So if the MCQ test is too tough, so most of the students from your class are scoring 10 marks, 20 marks, 30 marks, 40 marks or 50 marks, and very less students scoring more than 60 marks or 70 marks or 100 marks. In that case, your data will be more spread out on the right hand side. And if some student may feel the MCQ test is so easy, and some student may feel the MCQ test is so difficult, in that case your data can be all jumbled up, and you can notice it in the third figure. So these three scenario can be possible in your MCQ test mark. But in some of the biological variables like your height, like your weight, so suppose we record the weight or height or your mean hemoglobin count of your whole class, in that case you will notice that data will be spread, or that data will have the some central value and some of the commonest value at the central, and rarest value more or highest or lower side value on the lesser on less frequently. In that case your data will be the normally distributed. Let's see the concept of the normally distributed data. On the screen you can notice the example of the normal distribution of data. We can see the normal distribution of data in many biological variables. Biological variables like your height or your weight or your hemoglobin count or your WBC count or your red blood cell count, in which you can notice this normal distribution of data. In this data is tends to be around a central value with no bias towards the left or right. So you can notice in your class, suppose there are 60 boys are there in your second class, and you can notice the height should be around, average height should be 150 to 160 or 165 centimeters, because that is the central value. Some students having the higher, some student may be on the higher side having the 6 feet height or the 7 feet rarely. Maybe some student are the height around 140 centimeters or 150 centimeters, but most of the student will be will have the height between 150 to 170 centimeters. And if you plot it graphically or if you do the frequency distribution graph, you will see the peak that is around the 150 to 70, and the lesser variables on the less than 150 and higher than the 170. So it will give you the normal distribution. So in normally distributed data, mean is equal to median is equal to mode. If you not getting this point, please refer our first biostatistics lecture about the measurements of the central tendencies. So in normal distributed data, symmetry is about the center. 50% values are less than the mean and the 50% value are the greater than the mean. So you can notice a bell-shaped curve. So let's understand the concept of normal distribution in more details. Normal distribution or normal curve is graphical representation of data of naturally occurring variables or observations or biological observations, in which the term normal is used for usual or typical occurrence of the variables or typical frequency distribution, and it is not normality or abnormality in terms of biological terms. Means it does not suggest a abnormal blood pressure, means hypertension or hypotension. It is just a statistical term in which normal means usual or typical occurrence of the particular observations. It was first described in 1733 by English mathematician Abraham de Moivre, and in 1909 Gauss, who made first reference of it. So it also called as a, or also known as a Gaussian distribution. So sometimes the term used as a Gaussian distribution or normal distribution or normal curve. It is a theoretical, continuous, symmetrical, unimodal distribution of infinite range, and usually this normal distribution is, this curve depend upon the mean and the standard deviation, that is the number or frequency and the nature of the observations. Let's understand with one example. Suppose we have a data of 200 students of your class about your weights in kilograms. So there may be two observations. Most of are the common observations having the highest frequency, means most of the student will have their weights between 50 kg to 70 kg or 80 kgs, and there may be the uncommon observations, like some of the students will have their weights less than 40 kgs, and some of the students will have their weights more than 80 kg, 90 kg, but either on the higher side or the lower side, but with a less frequency. And if we plot this data and do the graphical presentation of this data, we will get a normal curve, which is also called as a simple frequency distribution curve, and after that we will get the normal distribution curve. Now let's understand the concept of normal distribution in more details. For that, you can see the two parameters which affects the normal distribution are on your screen. First parameter is your mean, and second parameter is your standard deviation. Mean means arithmetic mean or average of the all observations, and second one is the standard deviation. It is a measurement of the variability or the variation or the dispersion. It decides the width of the normal distribution, and it determines how far away from the mean the values tend to fall. Means how far away the all observations will fall away from the mean. Now let's focus on the two figures on the screen. In first figure, we can see that normal distribution with different means and the same standard deviation, in which the curve having the blue color, the mean is 100, and the curve with dotted lines and red color having the mean of 150, but both have the same area under the curve, or both have the same standard deviation. And let's took a second figure now. Let's focus on the second figure, in which we have the same means, means the bluer line as well as the dotted red line having their mean around the 100, or and we have the different standard deviation as the spread of the curve is different for the blue line and red dotted line. So this is how the mean changes the whole curve towards the right or left on the x-axis, while the standard deviation will decide how much will be the area under the curve with the help of the spread of the observations around the mean. Now, to understand the practical application of normal distribution in biomedical research or to solve exercises in your practical exams, you have to understand the empirical rule for the normal distribution. We have already learnt about the mean and the standard deviation. Mean means central value of all of your observations, and all of your observations will fall around that mean value, that is called as a standard deviation. Means either they will fall on the positive side or the negative sides, means they are more than the average value or the arithmetic mean, or they can be less than the arithmetic mean. As we seen in normal distribution curve, 50% values or 50% observations will be more than your mean, and 50% observations will be less than your mean. And in the table that is seen on your screen, you can notice mean plus or minus standard deviation, and second column is about the percentage of the data content. Means suppose you have the 100 observations or data about the weight of 100 students, then mean plus or minus one standard deviation if you take, and in that case you will cover the data or you will cover the observations of 68%, means 68% of observations will fall in mean plus or minus one standard deviation. If you take mean plus or minus two standard deviation, approximately 95% observations will fall between that around the mean. And if you take mean plus or minus three standard deviation, it will cover around 99.7% of the all observations. Let's take one example. Let's assume that pizza restaurant has a mean delivery time of 30 minutes. Means mean or average time of the delivery of the pizza for the particular brand is 30 minutes, and the standard deviation of 5 minutes, means plus or minus 5 minutes. So if you apply the empirical rule in this case, that means 68%, means if you take mean plus or minus one standard deviation, that will give you the 68% of the delivery times are between 25 to 35 minutes. How we can come to this? Here mean is 30 plus or minus one standard deviation, means plus or minus 5. So 30 plus or minus 5 will come to your 25 to 35 minutes. You can notice in the figure also. Second thing is mean plus or minus two standard deviation, it will cover around the 95% observations, means 95% means mean plus or minus two standard deviation, means 30 plus or minus 5 into 2, means 30 plus or minus 10, that will give you the 20 to 40 minutes, means 95% delivery times will be 20 to 40 minutes. And if you take mean plus or minus 3 standard deviation, it will give you the 99.7% observation will give you the 50 to 40 minutes of the delivery time. In figure that is seen on the screen, you can notice at the center there is a mean, that is the 30 minutes, and there are the three dotted lines on each side, means one standard deviation. So means one standard deviation means 68% of the observations, means 34 observations having the delivery times less than 30 minutes, and 34 observations in that case the delivery time is more than 30 minutes. That is the simple meaning of this mean and the standard deviation in terms of the normal distribution. As I said in the beginning, there are two important objectives of this particular lecture, that is to understand the two important concepts, that is normal curve or the normal distribution, And second concept is to understand the standard normal curve or the standard normal distribution. Up till now, we have seen or we have finished about the normal distribution or the normal curve. And let's start to understand the concept of the standard normal curve. But before we understand the concept of the standard normal curve or standard normal distribution, we should be thorough with our knowledge about the normal distribution or the normal curve or simple frequency distribution curve. Now, with this knowledge of the normal curve, let's start to understand the concept of the standard normal curve. To understand the concept of standard normal curve, first we have to understand the limitations of simple frequency distribution curve or the normal distribution or the normal curve. First, understand it. In simple frequency distribution curve, we represent the frequency with reference to the actual numbers and just with the mean and the standard deviation. But different characteristics have the different units of the measurement. Suppose we want to compare the usual or typical occurrence of the weight and the height in the same population or in the Indian population. In that case, the unit of the height is centimeters and unit of the weight is kgs. So if you want to compare the usual occurrence of these two variables, we require certain standardization. Suppose we want to compare the height of the two population, like Indian population and the European population. There are difference in their average height due to the ethnicity. So if you want to compare this height in the two population, their unit of measurement is same, but their mean and standard deviation will differ. So if we want to compare these two parameters, that is height in Indian population and height in the European population, we have to standardize and then we have to compare it. So this problem will be solved by this standard normal curve. To remove this limitation of the normal curve, we have to do the standardization of the normal curve. For that, we assume in standard normal curve that mean is equal to 0. Like in the example of pizza delivery time, the mean was 30, but we have to assume that mean is equal to 0. So central point of the curve is equal to 0, and that should be represented on the graph. And each measurement, not terms of the actual value but in terms of the units of the standard deviation, means suppose the delivery time in one observation is 35 minutes. So in normal curve, that at the center of the that normal curve, mean is equal to 30, and that particular observation on the higher side is 35. But in terms of the standard normal curve, the central point is, that is mean, is equal to 0, and that particular observation of 35, that we have to mark at the level of the 5, and that is called as a relative deviate, or it is a unit of the standard deviation, and it is expressed by the z. Remember, this z value will be very important for in solving your examples, and there is a z table that we are going to the details of that while solving the examples. But just remember that z value is also called the relative deviate, or it is a unit of the standard deviation. I will explain with the help of example in upcoming slides. Before we go ahead, please note down this formula on the screen into your journal or on the page, because this formula will be required while calculating or while solving the exercises related to this. So z is equal to x, x stands for observation, particular observation, minus m stands for mean, divided by the standard deviation. Whatever answer will come, that will give you the z value. And let's understand what is the use or application of this z value. Now let's understand the concept of the z value with the help of the example. Suppose we record the height of the 200 students of your class, and suppose the average or mean height of your class is 155 centimeters and the standard deviation is 2 centimeters. If we want to do the standardization, we have to assume mean is equal to 0. But first of all, we learn to calculate a relative deviate, or to calculate a z value of these four observations. To calculate a z value, we have to minus the mean from from all these four observations each time. Suppose we calculated z value for first observation, that is 157 centimeters. So to calculate z value, we have to minus mean, that is 155 centimeters, from 157 centimeters, and then divide with the standard deviation, that is 2. So z value for 157 centimeters will be plus 1. Like way, the z value for 159 centimeters will be the plus 2. For 153 centimeters, z value is equal to minus 1, and for 151 centimeters, the z value will be minus 2. On the screen, you can notice the properties of the standard normal curve. You can see that the standard normal curve is symmetrical and the bell-shaped curve. The mean, median and the mode are the same in standard normal curve. Mean is equal to 0. Area under the curve is equal to 1. Area under curve for mean plus or minus 1z is equal to 68%. Area under curve for mean plus or minus 2z is equal to 95%, and area under curve for mean plus or minus 3z, that will be 99% of the total area. And the theoretically, the curve does not touch the baseline. So here is the most important question that can be asked in your term end exam, because the properties of the standard normal curve are very important, but I don't want to mug it up. Please understand the these properties, as I have already explained these properties to you. Here, the difference between the standard normal curve and in normal curve, the difference is, in normal curve we have to mention about the mean plus or minus 1 standard deviation, mean plus or minus 2 standard deviation, or the 3 standard deviation. But in case of standard normal curve, we have to mention mean plus or minus 1z, mean plus or minus 2z, mean plus or minus 3z. Please remember this while writing the answer in your exams. Now let's understand the importance of standard normal curve with the example of apple and the oranges. Let's compare the apple with oranges. Suppose we have an apple that weighs 110 grams and an orange that weighs 100 grams. By looking at their weights, we can just say that apple has the greater weight or more weight as compared to orange. But that two fruits cannot be compared, because the two fruits are entirely different. So in that case, we have to standardize the apple and oranges in terms of their weight. For that, we have some data. That data is about the mean weight in grams of the apple is 100 gram, and the standard deviation for the apple is 15 grams. While for oranges, average weight is 140 grams and standard deviation is 25 grams. So we all know the formula of the z-score. Z-score is equal to particular observation minus mean divided by standard deviation. So let's calculate the z-score for apple. The apple given in example weighs around 110 grams. So 110 minus the mean. Mean for apple is 100. So 110 minus 100, that means 10, divided by standard deviation of apple, that means 10 divided by 15, and the answers comes to z score is equal to 0.667. That means our apple weighs more than the average apple, as the z score on the positive side. Now let's calculate the z score for the orange. In our example our orange weighs 100 grams and the average weight of the orange is 140 grams. So 100 minus 140, that will give us to minus 40, divided by the standard deviation for oranges is 25. So minus 40 divided by 25, so z score for oranges is minus 1.6, which means that our oranges weighs less than the average oranges. Same thing you can notice on the graph that is given on the screen. So apple in the example is more than the average z score, while the orange having the z score is equal to minus 1.6, that means it is lesser side on the z score. This is how you can compare apple with oranges literally with the help of the standardization, and this will give you by with the help of the standard normal curve. So this is the importance of the standard normal curve. Till now we have seen the concept and the importance of normal distribution and standard normal distribution and their curves. Now let's understand the practical application of the concept of the normal curve or the standard normal curve in research. So there are mainly two important practical applications. First application is making estimate of the number of individuals in any range of measurement, and second one is deciding common or uncommon measurements. Let's see with the help of the examples. Let's understand the first application, that is making estimate of number of individuals in any range of measurement with the help of example. Example on the screen is about height of a sample of 1000 adults. Of that 1000 adults, the mean height is 150 centimeters and the standard deviation is 2 centimeters. Now our task here is how many students will have height between 150 centimeters to 152 centimeters, means how many students will have their height between the mean height, that is 150 centimeters and the 152 centimeters. So in this example our task is to estimate the number of individual in this range of measurement, that is between 150 centimeters to 152 centimeters. So in other terms, we have to find out first area under the curve for the 152 centimeters. So the first step is, first we have to calculate a z value. Remember the formula for the z value. Z is equal to the particular observation, here it is 152 centimeters, minus mean, here it is 150 centimeters, divided by standard deviation, which is 2 centimeters. If we put these values in the formula, we will get z is equal to plus 1. So after that, second step, after you calculated the z score, that is plus 1 here, you have to refer the z table. This value will be provided in your exam, or we will provide you the z score table. Now let's see how to take the correct value from that z table. So in the right hand screen, on the in lower side, there is a screenshot of part of that table, and the red box is in that screenshot. So in the first column you have seen z values starting from 0 to 1.110. So the table is very large. I have just taken the screenshot of a part to understand you. So z value here it is 1, and in front of that 0.00 in second column, 0.01 in the third column, but here we our z score is just plus 1. So just match up that. In front of z score 1 there is a 0.00 value. The value for the z value for plus 1 is 0.3413. suppose our z score is 1.01, in that case you have to take the value in front of the z 1 and the third column, that is 0.01. that value is 0.3438. this is how you can select the exact value for your z value from that table. So in our case, z value 1 for z value plus 1, the area under curve is 0.3413. So out of the interpretation of this z value 0.3413 is, out of total area of 1, remember I have told you about the area under curve for the standard normal curve is equal to 1 and mean is equal to 0. So out of total area of 1, the area within m here it is 150 centimeters and 152 centimeters, or z value plus 1, that is shaded area that you can see on the in the figure of the that is shown on your screen, is equal to 0.3413. if we convert into the percentage, that means 34.13% area is under curve between these two measurement, that is between 150 centimeters to 152 centimeters. Now we have to calculate ki out of 1000 individuals, how many students will have their height between 150 to 152 centimeters. So if we convert into the thousands, we will get, or we will expect, roughly 341 individuals to have their height between the 150 centimeters to 152 centimeters. This is how you can estimate the range of measurement between the any two values with the help of this standard normal curve. So we have seen the example of practical application of concept of the standard normal curve. Now here I am giving you the homework or the journal work that you have to write into your biostatistics journal part. So let's begin. On the screen you can see the Z table or area under normal curve table. In your exams, either we will give you the Z value, so you will not require this table, or suppose in case we can give you this page, so you have to search for your area under curve for your Z value. And at this time when you are locked in your homes, you can search this table on internet. You will get this table easily, or any biostatistic journal, if you refer it in the appendix, you will get this table. So make use of this table correctly, as I have shown you in previous example. So here is the first homework or journal work. The example or the question is, the mean height of the 500 students is 165 centimeters and the standard deviation is 5 centimeters. Assuming the heights are the normally distributed, your task is to find how many students will have height between 153 centimeters and 183 centimeters. Now this example is quite complex. Here you have to find out the two Z values, one for the 153 centimeters and one for the 180 centimeters. So refer the previous example and now pause this video here. First solve this example by yourself and then refer to next slide for the correct answer. So hopefully you were able to solve this example correctly. So let's see the solution. In our example, mean height is 165 centimeters while standard deviation is 5 centimeters. Now our first step is to calculate a Z value for the two observations, that is for 153 centimeters and for 180 centimeters. The Z value for 153 centimeters is 153 minus mean, that is 165 centimeters, divided by standard deviation, that is 5. So Z value in first observation is minus 2.4. Like way, we can calculate a Z value for 180 centimeters, and in that case Z value is equal to 3. Now second and important step or crucial step to see the standard normal curve table and find out the area under the standard normal curve. So for Z value minus 2.4, the area under curve is 0.4918, and for Z value 3, the area under curve is 0.4987. Please refer the Z value table in previous slide or the internet. So if we sum the area under curve, the area under total area under curve is equal to 0.9905. If we convert it into the percentage or in terms of percentage, it will be 99.05. So out of 100, 99.05% area will be covered between these two observations. So interpretation of these results. Hence the number of students with the height between 153 centimeters and 180 centimeters will be 99.05% of the total students. So if we apply this percentage for the 500 students, we will get almost 495 students. So the interpretation or final interpretation is, 4 out of 500 students, 495 students will have their height between 153 centimeters and 180 centimeters. Hopefully you have understood the practical application of the standard normal curve with the help of the mean, standard deviation, Z value and Z value table or area under curve table. On the screen you can see the graphical representation of the example that we have seen just now. So on the screen you can see the bell-shaped curve. In that bell-shaped curve or standard normal curve, at the center point there is a M. M stands for mean, mean here it is 165 centimeters. On the left side there is a first observation, that is x1 is equal to 153 centimeters, and on the right hand side you can see the second observation, that is x2 is equal to 180 centimeters. The area under curve between these two observation is equal to almost 99.05. Now the second homework or journal work for you, the example or the question here: hospital records the weights of the every newborn child at the hospital. The distribution of weight is a normal shape. So here assumption is the data is normally distributed. Now the mean of the particular data or mean of the newborn child is 2.9 kg, and standard deviation is 0.45 kg. So this is the data provided to you. Now your task, first task is you have to calculate a percentage of the newborn who weighted under 2.1 kg. So here trick is we have not asked you to calculate the area under curve or the number of children between 2.1 to 2.9 kg. we have asked you to calculate the number of children below the 2.1 kg. so please understand the trick here. Second task is to calculate a percentage of the newborn who weighed between 1.8 kg and 4 kg. So here this particular range will also cover your mean part, and this particular example or particular task you can solve it with the help of the previous example. And third task is if 1500 babies are born at the hospital, how many weight less than 2.5 kg. so this particular example or task is again similar to the first example or first task. Here the trick is you don't have to calculate the number of children between 2.5 kg to 2.9 kg, that is a mean. Here what you want to calculate, you have to calculate, or we ask you to calculate the number of children below the weight of 2.5 kg. so how can you solve this? First you have to calculate the area under curve for between the 2.1 on 2.9 kg, and after that you have to minus it from the total number of area. So this is how you can solve it. The answers of this question is provided in the next slide, but before take a look of the next slide, please solve it by yourself by pausing this video. So let's see how you can able to solve the example. So hopefully you are able to calculate all the answers correctly, but make sure that you have to write all the steps in your exams to get the full marks. And the answer for the first task is 3.75% newborn were under 2.1 kg, 98.4% were between 1.8 kg to 4 kg, and third task is 0.1867 into 1500 is equal to almost 280 babies were below the 2.5 kg. so hopefully you all will be able to solve this example correctly. But if you not, please meet us when you join your college. We will help you to solve this example. Till now we have covered about the normal curve and the standard normal curve. In both these situation the data is symmetrically distributed. Now let's understand the concept of the skewness and the kurtosis. The skewness, which is the indicator, or it indicates the asymmetrical distribution. On the screen you can notice the example of skewness or asymmetrical distribution. It informs about the degree of asymmetry, and it tells us about the shape of the distribution and the size of the variation of all observations around the mean. So there are two types of the skewness. First type is positively skewed distribution, which is also called as a distribution is skewed towards the right. Now how can we decide the distribution is positively skewed or skewed towards right? As you can see, the distribution, the tail is towards the right side, and it is again on the positive side. That is why it is called as a positively skewed distribution. So here the relationship between mean, median and mode is mean is greater than median and median is greater than mode. Remember the relationship between the mean, median and mode in normal distribution curve. In normal distribution curve, mean is equal to median is equal to mode. Now let's see the second type of the skewness. On the right hand side in lower corner you can see the second example, that is data is negatively skewed distribution or skewed towards the left. As you can see, the tail is towards the left hand side or on the negative side. So in this case the mean is lesser than the median and median is lesser than the mode. So please remember these two types of the skewness while writing the example in while writing the answer in your exams. Now let's see the concept of kurtosis. The kurtosis is the Greek word having the meaning of bulginess. Now as we seen in previous slide, skewness indicates asymmetry in distribution. Now kurtosis measures the concentration of distribution at central part of a distribution. It deals with relative thickness of the distribution around the mode, or it deals with flatness of the curve compared to the normal distribution. Let's see the details of kurtosis. Let's understand the different types of kurtosis or different variant of kurtosis with the help of the figures. So there are three mainly variant or types. First one is a mesokurtic distribution. That means there is a zero kurtosis, where distribution that are moderate in breadth and the curves with a medium peak height. Usually this is compared or comparable with a normal distribution. Second variant is leptokurtic, that means a positive kurtosis. Here more values in the distribution tails and more values close to the mean, that is sharply peaked with heavy tails. And third variant is platykurtic or negative kurtosis. Here fewer values in tails and fewer values close to mean, that is curve has a flat peak and has more dispersed core with lighter tails. You can observe these things in the figures which is seen on the screen. So that figure will explain the concept of the kurtosis to you. So to summarize today's session, we have seen the concept of the normal distribution, standard normal distribution. After that we have seen the application of the concept of the standard normal curve and the normal curve. And in the last we have seen the asymmetrical distribution, that is the skewness as well as the kurtosis. So hopefully you have understood the background or concept of the all these terms, and hopefully you will be able to calculate the exercises in the journal and in your exams also. So please stay home, stay safe. Let's meet in the next lecture.